Well, look what came in the mail. John C. Evans, which we're going to look at. I have another book with his side of this. And Joseph F. Smith, Jr., the eldest son of Joe. I'll draw your attention here that Smith states that Joseph was killed for celestial marriage and teaching polygamy, which means that the people killing him had to know that they were killing him for his polygamy. So it was knowledgeable not only among Mormons, but among the population. This is worth reading. The first sentence here is, Brigham Young, who had been under suspicion at Joseph Smith's death, introduced polygamy and blood atonement at Salt Lake City, blah, blah, blah. So we're home. I got 40 years in the Mormon church, and why I left by... That's right, Mr. Evans. Then we've got the 1916 edition of the Blood Atonement Doctrine by Penrose. All right, so we got Joseph Smith, Blood Atonement, Evans, same stuff, Blood Atonement, 1916, published by the Mormon Church, Mountain Meadows Massacre, Penrose again. So you look at a series of photographs and look at this series of statements by Evans. This is what drove him out of the church, was this realization of blood atonement and polygamy and its relationship to the Mountain Meadows Massacre. So Evans wrote this in 1920. We're going to look at some of his statements concerning the dialogue with Smith and what occurred to him as he fled the Mormon hierarchy, of which he had been a part. Here's on Joseph Smith's death, Miss Eliza Snow, and polygamy. So it was these kinds of things that led Evans to flee and be prosecuted by his church, which he was successful in defending himself against. So this debate between Evans and Smith is more or less contemporaneous with the suicide of Abraham Cannon, Frank Cannon's brother, George Cannon's son. And that's another video. Because it's Smith that entered Abraham into polygamy. You can read about that in that polygamy suicide video. So if you want to see how disingenuous Mormons can be on the subject, just read this stuff. And these affidavits, which totally invalidate everything any Mormon would say on anything, because all of these affidavits are bullshit. And here's George Cannon lying. And here's George Cannon lying. Here's George Cannon lying.